Hi, my name is Michael Lukoc. I'm a product manager on the Power Virtual Agents, and today I would like to walk you through how to use the analytics and chat transcripts to improve the performance of your bot. On the left-hand side here, you can see in the chat test canvas a conversation that I have already had with the bot regarding gift cards and what my remaining balance is. And you can see that the conversation ran its course and the bot was able to help me. At the end, the bot asked, "Did this answer your question?" And I replied yes. This is synonymous with what we call our end of conversation survey. And this is important because it plays into what shows up as a resolved session. And then this is what we call the customer satisfaction survey, and that you will see played out in the customer satisfaction tab, where we ask the customer to rate the overall bot experience from terrible through excellent, which is 1 through 5. Let me walk us through what we have in terms of the analytics on the core summary view. You can see here the KPI header. You can also see that you have an ability to filter by the last 7 or 30 days. I'm sticking with the last 7 days here. You can see here we have 3 tabs: summary, customer satisfaction, and sessions. We will walk through all of them. What we see here is this particular bot had about 80 sessions in total, of which 88% have been engaged sessions. Now, what does that mean? An engaged session is one where the bot has been able to look at what the customer asked and find a topic that could potentially help solve the customer's question. So the bot was able to help with approximately 88% of sessions, which maps to about 70 sessions. So there were a couple of sessions that the bot wasn't able to help with, and those are defined as unengaged sessions. And those are reflected here in the red in this particular chart, the engagement over time. So this is one of the first areas that I would want to look in terms of being able to focus on what those questions were and seeing what content I could add, that new topics I could add to the bot to address those questions. Because the higher the engagement rate, the better performing my bot. And then let's look at this engagement rate. The 80 or so sessions that were engaged that really fall into 3 categories: resolved, or they are escalated, or they are abandoned. The example on the left is a session that was successfully resolved because the customer answered yes when asked, "Did this solve your question?" Only if the customer had specifically said no, would they be prompted to talk to a human, and this would be treated as an escalated. And then the abandoned are classified as those that the customer may have been engaging with the bot, but they dropped off partway through, perhaps because they thought that the bot doesn't understand or they got distracted and they left the conversation. When that happens, we wait for about 30 minutes or so before we classify this as an abandoned session. So the next area that I would look at in terms of being able to improve my content is really focus on having small number of escalation and abandoned to reduce it as much as I can. So the first thing I do is I look at the escalation rate drivers and I look at the specific topics here. So for example, the store locations and shipping policy. If I hover over, I can see the total impact. What this means is this particular single topic is impacting my overall escalation rate by 2%. You can also do the same analysis for abandoned sessions. Now, let's just take a quick look at what we have in the customer satisfaction tab. This view gives you a detailed overview of how each topic impacts the overall satisfaction with your bot. You can sort by the number of engaged sessions and see how your most popular topics impact your satisfaction. Or you can sort by the customer satisfaction impact to see which topic have the highest impact on the overall score. I would probably want to look at the lowest performers and the highest performers to see what is the difference and how can I improve the bot in those areas. So you can also see that the overall customer satisfaction with my bot is about 4.1 out of 5, which is not bad. And you can also see here that about 92% of people who were shown a customer satisfaction survey actually filled it in. Only 8% didn't complete it. The other thing to say is that for analytics to show up, you have to wait for about an hour to actually see the latest data. But when you download the sessions from the sessions tab, they show up immediately. So on the sessions tab, I can select a time frame and download all the sessions that happened in this particular time. And I have actually already done that just to save us a bit of time. So you can see here that I have an Excel file which is formatted as a table. And I'm going to filter this view by the abandoned and engaged sessions so that I can see which questions that were being asked the bot either wasn't able to help by they were not able to find the content, or the bot was not helpful and so the user abandoned the session midway. So I can see here that one of the common areas is that people ask a generic question saying, I have a problem. So this informs me that I should build a topic which handles such generic questions. We also see that there are some sessions which just say hi, and there are some joke questions. Now, there is one area that you can consider, right? Which is about what persona you want your bot to have. Should it be more serious, or do you want it to be also able to help answer some fun questions? It's up to you and something to consider. So another thing I would do here is I would go through the abandoned sessions and I would see which topics are causing people to drop off and perhaps rewrite those topics to make them more engaging or more helpful. And you can do that by looking at the transcripts of the engaged sessions and the ones that went well and learn from the topics that work well and improve the topics that don't work that well. So in conclusion, you will have to iterate and focus your customer content team to constantly improve the content because as you will find, the questions that the customer asks evolve over time and you will need to make sure that the bot keeps up. So thank you very much for listening.